Google Stadia. Pretty good, right?
What?
Yep.
This is the intro?
This is the intro.
Ah.
So today we found out pricing and availability for the service. We found out what games are on it, some of them anyways. We found out the network speed and the quality that we're gonna be expecting. And we also found out how we feel about it.
That's happening now. Right now, everyone.
Right now, on TalkLinked. Roll the intro. We don't have one. We don't. Okay, so what did we, really quickly, what did we know about Google Stadia before this stream? We knew that it was going to be a game streaming service.
Mm-hmm.
We knew that it had a controller that connected directly to the service instead of through your client.
You don't need the controller. You can use any other HID compliant controller.
That's right.
But for the best experience, you should use the Stadia controller.
Right.
It has Wi-Fi built into it, lots of other cool buttons.
We also knew that you could play it on basically any device, your TV, your laptop, your desktop PC, your mobile device.
Their goal is to have Stadia work with any device that can run Chrome.
Right.
But for now, it is known that the only mobile device you'll be able to use it on initially is the Google Pixel 3 and 3A.
Yes.
I wonder how long it's gonna be that it's only on those devices. I would assume that it'll eventually expand, and I would assume also that when the Pixel 4 comes out, that they're gonna want that to be a selling point.
Right.
You just buy the Pixel 4 and you can use Stadia. And then they'll probably want to have that be a thing for like 6 months or something.
True.
Before spreading it out further.
Yeah, the launch window is November, so that should be around when they're launching the Pixel 4. So that very well might be true. But for now, I think let's get into some of the details they announced on the stream. So what did we learn today? We learned pricing availability. So $9.99 a month for a Stadia Pro subscription. That gives you access to highest quality streams at 4K HDR, 60 FPS, 5.1 surround sound, and regular content added to your library.
So as I understand it, it's like Netflix in that way. You have access to the whole library, and that library is having things added to it.
No.
What are you talking about?
You're wrong, James. And I'm right.
Tell me everything.
In most things, actually. No, this is actually, I was actually a bit surprised. So you, 10 bucks a month, US, or $11.99 Canadian,
yeah,
gives you access to certain games. Like it sounds like there will be kind of free games, like indie games, as part of that library, that you get as part of your subscription, but you'll also have to buy the kind of AAA games. When you go on the website, it says games available for purchase through Stadia. And then when you look at the points for each of the memberships, it says you can purchase games with this subscription. So this is, let's get into this a bit. So there's the Stadia Pro, 10 bucks a month, and then there's the Stadia Base, that is no monthly subscription, and you can just buy games.
Yes.
On a per game basis, and you only get them at 1080p, 60 FPS, stereo sound.
Correct.
So it sounds like for, I guess this kind of makes sense. It sounds like for 10 bucks a month, you get access to 4K, Stadia, and some free games like you would get on Xbox Game Pass.
This is really interesting. It's not like a Netflix model. It's more like if you took the hardware cost of buying a console, you spread that out in $10 a month increments.
Yeah.
And kind of that's what you're paying.
And Xbox has a option for that. I forget what it's called, but Xbox allows you to basically rent a console.
Or finance it.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not sure whether it's financing or like you're just paying a monthly subscription for it, but like, yeah. So it seems like you're paying $10 a month basically to access the Google Stadia console on which you can buy games and on which you can also get free games.
That's really disappointing to me. I really thought it was like 10 bucks a month.
Yeah.
I thought it was gonna be like Google Play Music.
Now they will have that, like, so Destiny 2 is one of the high profile games that they said are like you'll get for free. It's funny because Destiny also just announced that their base game and all of the DLC from year one and the activities and the raids and stuff are all going free to play. So you can get it free to play on any platform you want, or you can get it with Stadia. Although Stadia will also give you the upcoming expansion like Shadowkeep for free as well.
And the Shadowkeep annual pass.
Yes.
Right, but what you're talking about, you don't get Destiny just with your Stadia Pro subscription. You get it with a Founders Edition package, which is something we need to talk about here.
That's very true. Yeah, it's unclear at this point whether that Destiny 2 experience will come with Stadia Pro or whether you need to get the Founders Edition specifically to get it. So we haven't talked about Founders Edition yet. You got Stadia Pro, which is the base, the $10 a month subscription. You got Stadia Base, which is you don't pay a monthly fee, but you can buy games on Stadia and play them.
At a
worse quality. And then you have Stadia Founders Edition, which is...
It's not analogous to those other two.
No, it's kind of a package.
It's kind of like a starting kit.
Yeah, so it's $129 a month.
No. It's $129.
$129. You get early access to Stadia when it launches in November.
If you want to play Stadia in 2019, you need this Founders Edition package.
You get 3 months of Stadia Pro, so that's $10 a month normally. You get 3 months of another subscription that you can give to somebody else,
a buddy pass.
And then you also get a limited edition Night Blue Stadia controller.
It's a nice color.
You can secure your Stadia name or your Stadia like gamer tag.
Which is actually pretty sweet. That's actually kind of a selling point for
me.
You get to be not only one of the first people to make sure you get the name you want,
right,
but you get a different name than other people because most people's names are gonna have a number just auto-appended to the end of their name.
Right.
So.
And I wanna get the first, Chode Blaster that's available.
Yeah, because there's no guarantee that you'll end up getting Chode Blaster 69. It could be 71 or something.
Yeah, I don't want Chode Blaster 71.
Yeah, who wants that?
What is this, Bush League?
71.
Okay, so it'll be available in 14 countries, including the US and Canada and a few other important ones. They're important, I guess. Okay, so games, let's talk games. Okay, so we got, they called these exclusives in the stream, but some of them are obviously games that are not exclusive, they're already available on other platforms, so I don't know.
Some of them are new, but they're gonna be on multiple platforms.
Baldur's Gate 3 is a new game. It sounds like that will be exclusive to Stadia, we're not sure. Ghost Recon Breakpoint, I'm pretty sure that's not an exclusive, but they said it was an exclusive. The Division 2, Assassin's Creed, Odyssey, Doom Eternal, Wolfenstein, Youngblood.
Hold on, because some of these, they said, here's what's gonna be available at launch, and then they played like 6 trailers in a row.
Right.
And I don't know if that means that those are the day one titles, and then the rest of the titles that they eventually talk about in their stream, are those just within the launch window? So do we have any information on what is gonna be available on day one and what's just in this launch window? And do we know how big this launch window is?
First of all, James, calm the F down. You are upset.
Yeah, I'm upset.
So they've listed like 30 games that, I mean, I think we can assume should be available at launch. If they're not, that's pretty bad.
I think if they're not day one, like 30 games isn't a lot. If they're not all there on day one, they gotta be there within 3 weeks or else.
Yeah, it's like you get early access to Stadia to play one game. That would be bad.
Not good.
That would be bad.
I'm interested in the games that they did list. There's a lot of variety. There's racing, there's like soccer, sports.
Yep.
There's, did you see this game called Get Packed?
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like Frogger meets Overcooked.
Yeah, it's kind of like a fun Overcooked style physics-based kind of craziness multiplayer game.
Yeah.
That looks cool.
Guilt looks cool. I want to play Guilt.
Guilt, yeah. They got some interesting like narrative-based games. But yeah, it will depend on how many more games they can get into the library and how many of them are going to be free. I'm upset.
I'm really disillusioned. I was really like, oh, cool. If I spend $130 and then $10 a month, that I don't need a console.
Yeah.
I don't need to do anything else. I can have that in my living room. That's going to be sweet. Now I'm not so sure. If I actually have to pay that on top of a per game cost, I don't know if I'm into it. Okay, and then on top of buying that stuff, am I gonna have to upgrade my internet?
James, sounds like you won't have to. I mean, if you have really horrible internet, maybe. But the minimum recommended requirement that they say is 10 megabits per second.
Which is for 720 stereo.
That'll get you 720, yeah. 60 FPS, but yeah, only stereo sound, 720p. Once you get up into the 20, 25 megabits per second range, you can get to 1080p, HDR, 60 FPS with 5.1 surround sound, and then 30 to 35 megabits per second will get you 4K HDR, 60 FPS.
35 is the recommended.
Yeah, so I mean, like, it's not bad for, like, requirements, especially considering that, like, I feel like a lot of people have 30 megabits per second, especially in urban centers.
The average in Canada is, like, 110.
Okay, wow. Yeah, so very impressive. Overall, I'm kind of disappointed that Stadia isn't really just like Netflix. That's what I was expecting.
I hope
that
you're
was
wrong.
A promise.
The website is kind of a little ambiguous, but I agree with you that it seems to look, according to your interpretation, it looks that way, I think.
Yeah. And I interpret things correctly, as we all know.
Yeah, I'm dumb. So bearing all that in mind, we want to know from you guys. Let us know in the comments, are you gonna buy the Founders Edition so you can play in 2019 and pre-order and all that stuff? Or do you think it's a safer bet to wait till maybe next summer once you know what games are available and how exactly it all works and what the experience is like latency-wise?
You could buy the Founders Edition now and then cancel it.
When? When are you gonna cancel it?
Whenever you want to.
You
it's
won't
a free
have
world.
You won't have any more information than you have now.
You have that freedom though. And that's, I think that makes us all feel good. See you later.